The overarching idea of this show is to celebrate and recognize the rich tradition of African American music, to examine the footprints of those musical giants who have illuminated our pathway to new artistic expressions. Welcome to this edition of Black Music Footprints, a jazz experience. Hello, and welcome to Black Music Footprints. It's all a jazz experience. My name is Mondre Moffitt. I appreciate you coming aboard with us on this show. Thank you for musing with me for a moment as we look at the footprints of jazz masters. And on today's show, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to discuss with you the songbirds of jazz music. Now, you know there are many, but I'm going to highlight special songbirds that had a large body of work. On a previous show, I talked about the young lions of jazz, but now it's time to give the songbirds of jazz proper due. Now, jazz singers, in my view, are threefold. They either fit into one or three categories in their approach. The first approach, these songbirds, they approach jazz from a very improvisational approach. They use scat singing, what we call freestyling in some other genres, but they use scat singing to improvise and masters of rhythm. They were, and very much steeped in the blues. Really cover the full spectrum of jazz music. And then the next approach category, I see some of these jazz singers would be masters of nuance. Masters of phrasing, the master lyricists. Many of them in this category would be a pianist and singer, starting that particular legacy. And so I want to call your attention to a couple of divas in that particular approach. And then the third approach, I would say, would be stylists. Not really one to go off on some scat singing so much, but simply maybe perhaps not a pianist, a strictly vocalist, but very much a stylist and employs very soft, subtle nuances as well. So there's always a combination of the three, but let's get involved with those three approaches. I thought I would set the stage in that regard. Now, the first lady of song is none other than Ella Fitzgerald. I know you can hear a lot more of that. Ella Fitzgerald, she defines that scat singing. She clearly defined what scat singing is all about. Her career spanned over 50 years. Impeccable diction and phrasing. The great Ella Fitzgerald. Ladies and gentlemen, what a way to start the show. But moving on, because I have another great singer who fits in the same category as Ella, Miss Sarah Vaughan.
out of beauty. Shadoo-doo, shadoo-doo-doo, I'll shoo be out of beauty. Shadoo-doo, shadoo-doo-doo, I'll shoo be out of beauty.
That you hear that note GL forever. They call her Sassy. Miss Sassy Sarah Vaughn. Wow, from Newark, New Jersey, multiple Grammy winner, NEA Jazz Master. Started her work in her teens with the pianist for Louis Armstrong, Earl Father Hines. Sarah Vaughn worked with him. And I'm putting it in the first category, that category, scat singer, you know, master of the blues influence aesthetic. But she can very well fit in the second category as well that I'll be talking about because of her mastery of the piano playing. I think she started with Father Hines and Billy Eckstein and those guys as a pianist. Got her name Sassy from appearing at the Apollo Theater as a young artist. And that name stuck. Someone called her Sassy in the way that she would deliver her performances, and that name stuck. Had no difficulty singing any particular intervals, just a master of harmony. I can't say enough about the divine one, as they call her, Sarah Vaughn. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. And now, another young lady, I like to call her, that is a part of that first category of this threefold approach to singing jazz. Her name, kind of obscure from the other two. You may not have heard of her as much, but her name, they call her Bebop Betty Carter. Bebop Betty.
Chops and roses and Crisco's on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with string. These are a few of my favorite things. Cream-colored ponies and crisp apple strudel, the velvet sleigh bells and schnitzels with noodles, walkies that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite things. Girls in white dresses and blue satin sashes, my nose and eyelashes, see the white winter that melt into spring. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I still remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things and that I don't feel.
Oh yes, oh yes indeed. Yes indeed. That was swinging, man. I was really, really, really swinging it. That note was reminiscent of a Sarah Vaughn, you know, the extended note, Betty Bebop Carter, a musician's a musician. And you just haven't heard the breadth of what she can do. When you go to New York as a young jazz musician, you want to play with Betty Carter. You want to play with Art Blakey. These jazz masters are no longer with us. So it's a little bit, New York is not the same as it used to be when you had these masters there to nurture young musicians. Many of them would come through her group. Many of the young lions that I spoke of in a previous episode would come through the Betty Carter group. Betty Carter from Detroit, grew up in Detroit, Michigan, and so prolific. That was a piece that John Coltrane made famous, really my favorite things. Another thing about Betty, she worked with Lionel Hampton. She came out of the Lionel Hampton Orchestra, as many of the greats like Quincy Jones, and Clifford Brown, trumpeter, and many of the greats come out of the Hampton group, Donald Harrison and Terrence Blanchard and Branford Marsalis, the list goes on. I mentioned Hampton and fascinated with him because he's from Louisville. Lionel Hampton is from Louisville, Kentucky. A little known fact, a fun fact that I enjoy musing about. I had a great pleasure of sitting down with Lionel Hampton on occasions and getting that wisdom from him. So now the second category that I want to talk to you and introduce you to, a second approach of this threefold approach that I'm designing for jazz singers, has to do with the piano and the vocal relationship. And in some cases, even extend further than the piano and vocal. But we there are musicians that play piano, vibraphones, and was a vocalist. So I want to introduce you to a couple of musicians, female singers, divas, who fit into this category with so much harmonic sophistication. Now, you heard one of them in Sarah Vaughan. But I have a couple more that will be a surprise for you. So I want you to stay tuned. And when I come back, we will revisit the songbirds of jazz music. We'll be right back.
The music department at Simmons College now offers a gospel track for its music performance degree. Our Department of Music exists to develop musical knowledge and skill. Students become beneficiaries of program features and faculty that distinguish music as both an academic and artistic discipline. Program options include brass and woodwind instruments, as well as guitar, bass, strings, piano, percussion, and voice. Your gifts will be encouraged and developed by a staff of experienced performing musicians and by the warm support of your peers. You will have frequent opportunities to perform, including vocal ensemble, gospel choir, jazz ensemble, marching band, and other ensembles, both on and off campus. Your music program can go no higher than those who lead it. Now is your time to build a strong music ministry from within. Help support passion already in your community. Help develop gifts already in your congregation. You might have the next James Cleveland in your church and don't know it. The heritage of artistic dignity found at historic black colleges and universities. The tradition of black excellence in gospel music. The calling to use your gift to turn hearts. Your journey toward obtaining a bachelor's degree in music starts now. Simmons College of Kentucky. Apply today. Become a part of the legacy.
Welcome back. to Black Music Footprints, the Jazz Experience. I want to talk to you right now about the master of nuances. I'm speaking of singer-pianists. These singer-pianist musicians have a very good understanding of harmony. They're great storytellers, and they have impeccable delivery. These particular singers with this approach, sitting at the piano and being able to deliver a lyric with a high level of authenticity when it comes to harmony, rhythm, and melody. First singer, none other than the great Shirley Horn.
Fly with me, come fly, let's fly away. You can use some exotic booze. There's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me, come fly, let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Come fly with me, let's take off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just lie starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. Cause we're together, weather-wise, it's such a lovely day.
I better cut that off now before I just get lost totally in the warmth of her sound. I'm digging on those brushes on the drums are really sweet and nice and warm as well. The great Shirley Horn, she's sitting at the piano, impeccable delivery, a master. In this African-American music, the great Shirley Horn. My goodness. A master of subtleties. You have to listen to her many times to really get the full spectrum of who she is and her delivery and what she brings to the table. Just some feel-good music, right? Whew. Now, I need a moment. But here we go. Here is a young lady born in Harlem, right at the beginning of the Harlem Renaissance. 1920 was her birth, and ended up playing piano at the famous clubs in Harlem with Dizzy Gillespie and Charlie Parker. She was introduced to those guys. And so, here she is.
Won't you stop and take a little time out with me? Just take five. Stop your busy day and take the time out to see I'm alive. Just so I can pass by each day. Not a single word do we say. It's a pantomime and not a play. Still I know our eyes often meet. I feel tingles down to my feet. When your smile that's much too discreet sends me on my way. Wouldn't it be better not to be so polite? You could offer a light. Start a little conversation now. It's alright. Just take five. Just take five.
All right, I know I didn't say who she was. That's the great Carmen McRae, probably one of the most influential jazz vocalists of the 20th century. Definitely a master of the nuances, pianist. If I'm not mistaken, she played piano with Mercer Ellington, who was Duke Ellington's son. Many of the groups would hire her on piano. That's just how prolific Carmen McRae was. That was Dave Brubeck's Take Five. She was doing a rendition on. I love her voice, Carmen McRae. Again, piano vocalist masters. Now, moving along, this third category of this threefold approach in jazz singing deals with style, being a stylist. And this singer, I think she stands apart for many reasons. Before I tell you who she is, but know this, she was came up in Chicago, and she was the lead singer for the Sally Martin Singers. You know, that's a leading gospel group, pioneering gospel group, Sally Martin. This person was in that group and was one of the lead singers. Also, she played in her teenage years piano for one of the main gospel churches there in Chicago. So she's steeped in this type of black culture, the spirituals, gospel music, blues, very steeped. And here she is now in New York, she was originally born in Alabama, but raised in Chicago. Here she's now in New York, performing with none other than Quincy Jones. I'm talking about Dinah Washington.
Grab your coat and get your hat. Leave your worries on the doorstep. Just direct your feet to the sunny side of the street. Now can't you hear that pitter-pat? And that happy tune is your step. Life can be so sweet on the sunny side of the street. I used to walk in the shade with those blues on parade. I'm not afraid. This rover has crossed over. Now if I never had a cent,
yeah, baby,
I'd be rich as a Rockefeller. Gold dust at my feet on the sunny, sunny side of the street. I used to walk in the shade.
Dinah Washington, ladies and gentlemen, she also an alumni of, guess who? Lionel Hampton, along with Quincy Jones, Lionel Hampton. You know, along with some of the others we mentioned. Before, it's a long list of this native son of Kentucky did good the way he nurtured these musicians. And Sunny Side of the Street, Dinah Washington, man, unmistakably Dinah Washington, song stylist. And guess who followed in her footsteps? Dinah Washington's original song stylist. This is the third category I'm speaking of in this threefold approach to jazz singing. So she would be the original song stylist. But the song stylist, I like to remind you, for those of you who don't know, would be this lady.
Wish I knew why I'm so in love with you. No one else in this world will do. Darling, please save your love for me. Run away. If I were wise, I'd run away. But like a fool in love, I stay and pray you'll save your love for me. I can feel it.
Nancy Wilson. And by the way, that was Cannonball Adderley on alto saxophone, the great Cannonball Adderley, Nancy Wilson collaboration. Can't beat that. You can't beat it. Her big hit, I almost played, Guess Who, I saw today, was a really, really big hit. And I almost played that. And we don't have time for me to play it, but I'm really in a Nancy Wilson mood right now. Ladies and gentlemen, it's just, these are masters of this African-American music, the many different performance traditions, even within the female vocal approach. The performance tradition is diverse. And so we are a part of this really, really rich culture that we should all be very proud. This is a celebration. And, okay, I said there were three categories. Now, here's someone beyond category. And this is my final sampling, the snippet of this show. I started with, what is it, the first lady of song. I'm going to end with Lady Day. None other than Billie Holiday.
It was just one of those things, just one of those crazy flings, one of those bells that now and then rings, just one of those things. It was just one of those nights, just one of those fabulous flights, a trip to the moon on gossamer wings. Just one of those things.
I better get out of here. I don't have time to go further. I better get my derby and my top coat and get out of town. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time to play the name game, and you know how it goes. The first name I will give you is the first lady of song. What would you say? Ella is my response. What about Sassy Sarah? What would you say? Sarah Vaughn. What about Lady Day? And there it lies, Billie Holiday. It has been indeed a pleasure. Thank you for joining us here on this great network, SSC Live TV, where truth, justice, and power always prevail. My name is Mondre Moffitt.